Hey everybody, Mark Edward Lewis here from cinemasound.com. Today we're going to be using Adobe Premiere Pro to show us how to do and where the good sound button is. You know, the good sound button where you just have to hit a single button or move a couple of dials and everything sounds great. That is available for us in Adobe Premiere Pro in the form of the Multiband Compressor plugin. Let me show you how.
All right, so we're here in Premiere Pro where we have a little clip of just dialogue from a lavalier. It's a little chunky. It's got a little noise from the room, and it's kind of honky, as lavaliers many times are. Let's take a listen to what this sounds like.
It's insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer.
So you kind of get, I mean, it sounds fine. It's well recorded. It's just in a kind of a noisy room. So the first thing that we need to do is instantiate, get rid of the stuff that we don't want. And that's as easy as pulling up a high pass filter. Because stuff that is below 90 hertz, generally speaking, even in the male voice, we might cheat a little bit and make it 85, is just not human. And we don't need it rumbling down there. The next thing that we do is we want to deal with this noise. And we just instantiate denoise, double click, and this will come up. Take a look at what we're seeing here.
There was insubordination that give, but you're taking unnecessary risks.
Now that's the actual sound itself. As we bring up the amount of reduction, you'll see a red bunch of indicators come in.
That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination that give, but you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination that give,
and that's pretty good. This is with a full broadband frequency attenuation. If we just do the low frequencies, listen to the difference.
But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
And really, I think most of the noise is down there in that low rumble of the air conditioner.
But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks.
And without
that stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
And there's a little bit of chirpiness in there, but I think it's okay. Obviously, we can reduce it if we need to. Then from there, the only other plugin I would want to use, and a lot of people do a lot of other things, is the multiband compressor. We double click. And this is really like having four compressors in one that are bound to a specific kind of frequency. So here we are. We're going to be moving these little bars around, which tell each one of those compressors, the blue, orange, green, and purple, lavender, what their lane is. And we want to take the first one and make it kind of the low frequencies of the voice, the next one to be kind of the honky sound of the voice, the next one to be kind of the edge of the voice, and then this top one becomes the sibilance and basically becomes a de-esser. Take a listen to what this sounds like. This is the low band. This is that honk band.
Insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks.
And then here is the edge.
That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
And then sibilance.
But you're taking unnecessary risks.
Pretty simple. So we're going to link bands. We're going to do a 4-to-1 ratio. We're going to make the attack about 50. We're going to make the release about 75 milliseconds. And then we're going to start bringing down the threshold.
That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks.
And you can see it's now doing a bit of EQ because the red bars are attenuation. So it's attenuating some more of these honky frequencies, edgy frequencies, than the sibilance or the bass. We're going to bring up the gain a little bit to compensate.
Stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks.
Now with the sibilance, we want to control these. Oops, I want to unlink this here. We want to control these sibilance a little bit more. So we're going to bring that attack down.
That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
And we might be doing a little too much, so we'll bring the threshold up.
But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was...
Now sibilance are being controlled really nicely. We still have a lot of honkiness.
Insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks.
So let's bring the threshold down a little bit more, maybe a lot more.
That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
And we can also sharpen up the attack so that it's really biting it and keeping it quiet.
But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
And what's great about doing the multiband compressor is that it's not only just bringing the volume down like an EQ, but it's also keeping it contoured. Now, I want to recover some of the bass frequencies of his nice, rich voice that we've lost. And what we can do is I don't want to lose the control that I have. You can see that it's attenuating.
But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was in.
And maybe I want to slow it down just to give it a little more of a contoury kind of mastering, easy contour. But I want to keep that control. But instead of just bringing up the threshold, which will make me lose that control, I'll just bring up the straight gain itself. Take a listen to what this sounds like.
Insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
And now we might actually bring up the gain on the highs a little bit more.
Subordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks.
Just give it a little bit more edge. So compare this with a raw version of what we started with. That's this track down here, just without any EQ or anything on it.
That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination. But you're taking unnecessary risks. That stunt in the destroyer was insubordination.
Massive difference. And just with a few quick plugins, we've got a much, much better sounding, situation. And we can save this as a preset so that anytime this actor shows up with this microphone, we can just drop this in on a channel and we're good to go.
It's so powerful. And perhaps the multiband compressor in Adobe products like Audition and Premiere is one of the best, if not the best sounding post-production multiband compressor that's included with an NLE or DAW anywhere. I love it. It's easy to use and just makes beautiful things out of mud sometimes. In fact, I've used multiband compressors at shows to help denoise things that are otherwise completely unintelligible from podcasts. So you can try that as well. I've got videos on that in our YouTube channel here. Please subscribe to us here if you found this valuable and enjoy those hundreds of other videos that we have to help you get that Hollywood level million-dollar audience impact into your production. And of course, join us at cinemasound.com, where we have hundreds of articles to help you learn how to do that in even more detail, as well as the world's only fully comprehensive education on sound for picture that takes you from knowing nothing about sound all the way to being able to deliver great deliveries and deliverables in a Dolby 5.1 surround. Hopefully we'll see you there. If not, we'll see you in post. Even if you're for yourself.